Okay, in second session, we are going to complete one small chapter there in your study material separately. So for a CA study material is concerned, it is merged with PGVP. Okay, it's a part of business. Alright. But in your study material, it is given as a separate chapter. So let's go and treat that separate chapter. So in sequence, we will be done with third chapter today. Alright. So chapter 1, 2 is done. This is third chapter. I personally call this as the taxation of agriculture income. Your module called agriculture income. Study note 3. Okay. So give the heading in your book, notebook. Alright. Study note 3. Taxation of agriculture income. Taxation of agriculture income. Study note 3, taxation of agriculture income. Study note 3, taxation of agriculture income. Likha. Shanti, shanti abhi. Taxation of agriculture income. What to write in that chapter, that I'll show you now. Okay, there are a lot of points. We have to write it point wise. 2 points you already know. Indian agriculture income, exempt under section 10(1), and foreign agriculture income, taxable. These 2 points you already know. So let's come to that. Taxation of agriculture income. You have given heading first point. Write down point wise and then leave presentation line. First point. Indian agriculture income is equal to exempt under section 10(1). Indian agriculture income exempt under section 10(1). Lik tu dhun mat. Indian agriculture income exempt under section 10(1). Very important. It's like people take this chapter very lightly, but it's not like that. We professional must take it very very seriously. Sir, how seriously you have taken it? I am becoming farmer. What else I should tell? I have taken that seriously. I'm leaving Mumbai and becoming farmer. Second point, foreign agriculture income taxable as IFOS or PGBP. If it is your main activity, then PGBP. If it is your additional activity that you are doing, then IFOS. Foreign agriculture income taxable as IFOS or PGBP. Okay. Wait now. Now please listen. Okay. Don't write this. Please listen first. I am going to teach you rule number. Okay. I am going to teach you rule number. There are a lot of rules. Rule 7, A7B and rule 8. Okay, there are a lot of rules of Income Tax Act. Now, income tax rules. We are going to study income tax rules. So, say for example, you are earning composite income. Okay, the third point that we are discussing, the heading of that point is composite income. Okay, composite income. Composite income means hybrid income. Hybrid income means there are two income, commercial income and agriculture income. Say few examples of these activities. Say for example, I am a sugar factory and I cultivate my own sugar cane and I process only those sugar cane. Okay, so that is my own sugar cane. Cultivating sugar cane is agriculture activity. Converting sugar cane into sugar is a commercial activity. I am Kisan Jam. I plant my own fruits. Okay, I extract those fruits and I make my own jam. Alright, so making jam is a commercial activity, whereas doing that cultivation or plantation of fruits is agriculture activity. You are getting my point? Alright, sir, you can take tomato ketchup. I am producing my own tomato, then I am making my own tomato ketchup. I have mango plantation. Through that, I am making mango syrup or mango pulp, or I am making this jams, alright, or maza, any cold drink like that. Okay, so this is how it has to go. Like, you are doing two activities. One part of that activity is agriculture and the second part, the processing part, is a commercial. Are we clear about this? So in this case, what is going to happen, sir? How to do? Because our thoughts are clear. that agriculture means exempt and commercial means taxable. These are our thoughts. Agriculture exempt, commercial taxable. In my case, I am doing both. So taxable or not taxable? Fully taxable or partly taxable? If partly taxable, then how much taxable, how much not taxable? These questions will arise, yes or no? This is PGBP, yeah? This is a part of PGBP. It's a business. It's an agriculture business. Okay, it's a business, but it's an agriculture business. Now, what is going to happen here? Please understand, there are agriculture activities, agriculture income, and there is agriculture and commercial activities. Agriculture activities and commercial activities. So, which finished goods I will sell in market? Maybe commercial product. Okay. अगर मैंने जैम सेल किया तो कमर्शियल प्रोडक्ट सेल किया तो सेल्स यहाँ क्रेडिट होगा. ओके, मैंगो सेल किया तो यहाँ क्रेडिट होगा. एग्रीकल्चर प्रोड्यूस किया तो, समझा? हेलो, सेलिंग प्राइस यहाँ क्रेडिट होगा, कोई प्रॉब्लम यहाँ पे? आई मीन महाबलेश्वर एंड वी आर हैविंग स्ट्रॉबेरीज प्लांटेशन देयर. समटाइम आई सेल स्ट्रॉबेरीज एंड समटाइम आई प्रोसेस स्ट्रॉबेरीज इनटू जैम एंड देन आई सेल जैम. Lot of people are doing it there, alright. So it's not that if I'm processing it, I will sell only processed product. No, you can also sell agriculture product, alright. So whatever sale you are having from agriculture product, actual sale, that you will credit here. And agriculture, some of your agriculture produce will be used for commercial produce. You are done with process costing? Done? Process costing, at least some idea of process costing, some part in your life. Yes. Process costing, process 1, process 2, process 3, something like that happens. Output of process 1 becomes input of process 2. Yes or no? For me, process 1 is agriculture and process 2 is going to happen in factory. So if this is my agriculture plant, please understand, if this is my farm, okay, this is my farm and I am cultivating in all those farm and this is my factory. Alright, so this is P1 for me, process 1, and this is process 2. First I will do process 1, and in trucks, okay, these are trucks, huh? These are trucks, do not assume anything, these are trucks, okay, trucks, from aerial view, they are going in factory, okay, they are taking our raw material in factory. So at what price process 1 should do give it to process 2? At cost price or at market price? Hello, at cost price or at market price? So we have said here at market price. Okay, you sell it at? Because agar tere paas ye nahi hota, to tu tomato kahan se lata? Market se lata. At what price? That would have become your cost price. तो तेरे लिए प्रोसेस के लिए कॉस्ट प्राइस इज इक्वल टू मार्केट प्राइस. ओके, तेरे पास ये नहीं होता तो तू टोमेटो के साथ क्या करता? मार्केट में जाके सेल करता. यू वुड हैव सोल्ड इट इन मार्केट एट व्हाट प्राइस? मार्केट प्राइस. तेरे लिए सेलिंग प्राइस इज इक्वल टू मार्केट प्राइस. ओके, तो ऑल्दो यू आर यूजिंग इट फॉर योर ओन कंपनी, फॉर योर ओन प्रोडक्शन, वी नीड टू क्रिएट प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट इन टू डिफरेंट कॉलम. हेलो, and therefore here I will credit sale as fair market value of the product. Yes or no? All right, and then I will start writing cost or expenses. Hello, then I will write cost of cultivation. Cost of cultivation kidhar debit karu? Isme ki isme agriculture cost of cultivation kaun se division ka cost hai? Agriculture, to idhar minus hoga. Cost of manufacturing cost, overhead cost, factory workers, यहां से माइनस होगा. ओके, रॉ मटेरियल कॉस्ट, सीड परचेस करके लाया, सीड तो एग्रीकल्चर, इसके लिए कुछ और परचेस, केमिकल्स वगैरह लाया, कमर्शियल. हेलो, इसका सेल, ये फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू, वो भी तो इसका रॉ मटेरियल है, तो इसका ये कॉस्ट है, फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू यहां से माइनस होगा, क्योंकि अगर मैं नहीं ट्रांसफर करता तो मार्केट से मार्केट पे प्राइस पे लाता. ओके, लॉजिक क्लियर हो रहा है सर? ऐसे करके देन देर आर वर्कर्स हु आर वर्किंग हियर, उनका सैलरी यहाँ से माइनस होगा. देर आर वर्कर्स हु आर वर्किंग हियर, उनका सैलरी यहाँ से होगा. देन देर इज वन मैनेजर जो दोनों जगह पे काम करता है, अलोकेट होगा. ओके, वन ट्रक इज देयर व्हिच इज यूज फॉर बोथ एक्टिविटी, डिप्रिसिएशन विल बी अलोकेट, देर विल बी रेशियो, मैनेजमेंट नो दैट, नो दोज रेशियोज. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ इट गोइंग टू हैपन, एंड देन यू विल गेट प्रॉफिट. दिस इज एग्रीकल्चर प्रॉफिट एंड दिस इज कमर्शियल commercial profit, taxable agriculture profit, not taxable. मैंने क्या बोला समझा? Commercial profit, taxable agriculture profit, not taxable. इतना तो समझ में आया? Now if you know this is not taxable and this is taxable, what kind of planning you will do? What kind of evasion you will try to do? बोलो ना, इधर का expenses उधर जाएगा, इधर का expense इधर नहीं आएगा, इधर का expense उधर, tractor का depreciation यहाँ होगा claim, okay? होगा ना? Possibility है कि नहीं? I'm just talking about possibility. Will you do it? There are two workers. One is working in agriculture farm and one is working in factory. You will try to record both expenses in commercial. You will think that how come income tax is going to come here and getting insight of what is happening here and what is not happening. So I will give him check from commercial account. Hello, possible no? People will try to do this. Yes or no? Tomorrow I become farmer. I will also try to do this. Hello?
Yes.
Everybody will try to do this. Should there be any control from income tax?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, and that is section 14. 14A. I told you 14A is a guarding section. 14A guards that nobody should claim any expenses incurred for exempt activity. Not only agriculture. Any expenses which is incurred for against taxable activity. That's a guarding section, and it's not guarding only PGBP head, it's guarding all five heads, and therefore it is sitting outside the heads at entry point. Yes or no? So that is the logic of section 14A. I just wanted to open discussion of 14A. I never intended to teach 14A. I'm not teaching you 14A. I just told you that something like this is there in section 14A. If you try to evade like this, then already guard is there, and this is tax evasion. It's not planning. It's not avoidance, it's a tax
evasion.
Shifting expense from here to here is a tax evasion. We already have anti-tax evasion mechanism here. Okay, pakka?
Yes.
Cool, can I go ahead?
Yes.
So, if you have understood this, okay, then I would like to take my discussion further. So usually you need to maintain separate books of accounts, yes or no? What did I show you now? Separate P&L for commercial activities and separate P&L for agriculture activities. Is it easy task or little complicated in nature? Determine fair market value, record common manager, then see how many days he has worked here and then how many days there. So it is complicated in nature. Yes or no? And this commonly happens with TCR. In case of TCR, it is very much common. Okay? These three crops are very important crops of India. Tea, coffee, rubber. Alright? These three crops are very important. Why important, sir? First of all, these three crops were never invented in India. They are not Indian crops. Someone else has brought these crops to India. Maybe Britishers, maybe someone else. Okay? So somebody from outside India has brought these crops to India. And now India is one of the global exporter, leader in global export business for TCR. Okay, so these three crops brings immense money, immense foreign currency to government of India. These sentences I said so that you should give me answer to one question which I'm about to ask. Will government encourage these three crops or discourage these three crops?
Encourage.
Obviously encourage. How to encourage, sir? By giving tax concessions or by levying high taxes? By giving tax concessions, alright, and maintaining this type of profit and loss account was difficult for them, because you go to Assam, you go to Munnar in Kerala, hello, you go to EDK district, you can see majority companies are having their own plantation there. Tata have their own plantation system there. Tata tea is there, no? They are having their own plantation. It's not that they are buying it from some farmers. They have their own mountains, their own plantation. They take their own leaves and then only they dry it, and then there's a process of cleaning and drying, sun drying, machine drying, then sorting, alright, then taking good leaves, then processing it into powders, then flush 1, flush 2, flush 3, alright, flush 1, 2, 3 is export quality, tea that we get is flush 4 or flush 5 or flush 6, All right, first three qualities of tea doesn't require milk, doesn't require sugar. They are healthy teas. We don't buy it, we don't drink it, because we feel that, oh, maza nahi aata usme. Maza is there in fourth flush, fifth flush. Boil karo, sugar dalo, milk mix karo, all right, and spoil whatever it was there, original, all right. But we don't get it. Culture will change. You go to Assam and all this thing, they don't mix. There is no culture of mixing milk and sugar into tea. Tea means tea. They drink it as a tea. Only tea. Tea is the product itself. Why do you want combination of 3-4 more item in that? Okay. Here in Mumbai, what do you get? Masala tea. It's like they are making biryani. They are putting all masalas into tea. They are making it. What can we do? Alright. So tea, coffee and rubber. These three crops are very much important. Government is encouraging them. Maintaining separate P&L was not possible, or even if it's possible, government said, don't maintain. Why are you making your life complicated? You people are good people. Let us make your life simple. Okay. So in TCR, there are three options, first of all. Please understand those three options. Either you only grow it. You don't process it. You just grow it. If you are growing it, then it's 100% agriculture income, no tax. Then you might be a company which only manufactures. You take tea leaves, you take this coffee beans, or you take raw rubber from these farmers, and then you are processing it. You are MRF tire. You don't have your rubber plantation. You are taking rubber and you are making tires. Hello?
Yes.
All right. Then the activity that you do is 100% commercial, fully taxable. All right. And then the third part is composite income. Okay. Or composite business, whatever you say, composite income. Okay. In this, you do two activities. What is two activities? Grow and manufacturing. Growing and manufacturing. If you are doing this, then they have standard rules in our income tax. Okay. As per that rule, rubber has to be divided into agri income and commercial income. Agri income and
commercial.
You don't have to prepare separate P&L account. You just maintain common P&L account, common profit and loss account. Credit all incomes, debit all expense. Okay. And then you will get profit. That profit we will divide into two ratio. Standard. Okay. 65-35 is the ratio that you have to buy at. 65-35. What is the ratio of rubber? 65-35. Now in exam you will go and you will be confused. 65 taxable or 35 taxable? You understand? This confusion will be there. You will not forget ratio. 65-35. But in exam confusion will be 65 taxable or 65 exempt. So therefore I ask you, government is trying to encourage these businesses or discourage? Encourage means more tax or less tax?
Yes.
Less tax means more exemption.
Yes.
And more exemption means government is giving 65% agriculture and 35% commercial. If you do reverse, then you are discouraging it. Even if I am asking you, 70% is commercial in real life. Only 30% is agriculture. But government said no. You take 65 agriculture, only 35 commercial. Tomorrow you had 100 crore profit. Tax only on 35 crore, 65 crore exempt. Good? If you are a Tata Tea, 1000 crore profit, 600 crore exempt, 400 crore taxable. What is the ratio for tea? What is the ratio for tea? 60-40. Agriculture income 60, commercial income 40. Rubber 65-35, tea 60-40. Okay. Now coffee. Coffee is interesting. Okay. In coffee there are two types. In coffee we have two types. Okay. One is raw coffee. Some coffee lovers are here. Only coffee lovers. Yeah. Only coffee. You people don't drink. Don't drink tea. Only coffee. Okay. Now they understand what types of coffees are there. Okay. For us ordinary janta, we don't you cannot determine what type of different coffees are there. Okay, you go to any coffee shops, CCD and all, they will give you 5-6 different menu minimum. Alright. Different, and you will not understand what is cappuccino, what is this like and that, you know. For you, to you like cappuccino, latte. This. एक्सप्रेसो हाँ आई ओपनर मुझे नहीं पता था आई ओपनर क्या होता है आई ऑर्डर आई ओपनर दे गिव डायरेक्ट स्ट्रॉन्ग कॉफी इन वेरी स्मॉल कप टाइनी कप एंड यू हैव टू टेक इट एज शॉट वन शॉट ओके इट्स वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग नो शुगर नो मिल्क आई ओपनर नहीं वो आत्मा ओपनर था Alright. So there are a lot of types of coffees we get. Alright. The ordinary people that we drink coffee is like Nescafe and something like that. Brew that we open, we put it in milk, we put sugar, we mix it and we drink it. That coffee is fully processed coffee. Okay. Name of that fully processed coffee is, okay, grown, obviously it is grown, cured, roasted. There is a procedure of roasting. I had personally seen all those steps when I visited Eduki last time. Alright. I have seen these processes practically how they do it. One, grown, cured, roasted and grounded. Then they make powder. Okay. First they roast it and then they make grind. They grind it. So grind it. Grown, cured, roasted and grounded. There is no difference between this and tea. Okay. Because sometime in my house, if I have time, I make tea. Because I'm a tea lover. And if I don't have time, then I make coffee. The coffee that I make takes less than 2 minutes to make. Because boiled milk, put coffee powder into it, drink it. It's that simple. Alright. That coffee, shortcut coffee is this coffee. Grown, cured, roasted and grounded. Isme aur isme farak nahi hai. To percentage mein bhi farak nahi hai. Percentage kitna iska? 60-40. So this is, we are indifference between coffee and tea. This is aam janta. But then there are coffee lover in house. They don't like coffee like this. They like to make their own coffee. Okay. I have seen one crazy faculty in Karnataka. He had his own mug, coffee mug, that electric mug. Okay. In that he puts coffee beans. He carries coffee beans with him, not coffee powder. He with him, his own hand, he smashes those coffee beans. He keep it there. That's some process that he have to do. Sometime he put that particular coffee to filter at night and morning he will drink. Alright. So these are some processes there. That coffee, the guy who was drinking it was a raw coffee. Alright. Semi-processed coffee, you can say. So only two processes are done. Grown and cured. Grown and? So what is not done? Roasted and grounded. These two processes are it to be done. Alright. But still you can buy this particular coffee beans. There are people who are selling these coffee beans in market. Only grown and cured. Only these coffee beans are sold. Now you tell me here, I don't feel there is lot of agriculture activity. There is lot of commercial activity involved here. Here there are four steps of commercial activity. Grown is agriculture. Then cured, roasted, grounded. Alright. Here only two steps. Grown, cured. Alright. So you tell me here agriculture proportion should be more than this. Or less than this? Agriculture proportion should be more than 60% or less than 60%? More than 60% because commercial operations are less. So more percentage shall be allocated for agriculture 75-25. Okay. So in coffee we are having two possibilities. In rubber there is no confusion. 65-35. In tea, no confusion, 60-40. In coffee, if four words comes in exam, even if roasteds come in exam, sometimes they don't give four words. Directly they say roasted coffee. Roasted coffee means it reached to last and second last process. Hello? Alright, so roasted and grounded, 60-40 and only grown and cured, 75-25. Are we clear about this? Apart from these three products, if any other product is there, we don't have standard ratios for them. They must maintain separate books of record. Okay. Are you guys clear about this?
Yes.
Chalo. So this is next point that you people have to write. This is very good chart, a big size chart. Then you start writing. I'll tell you on which page you have this chart. Tea, coffee, rubber. It's not that clear because its background white nahi kiya hai. Okay, tea, coffee and rubber, TCR. Please understand. Only growing. Come on, tell me. Only growing is what? Agriculture income. Taxable or exempt? Exempt under section 10(1). Only manufacturing. Business income? Fully taxable as a PGPP because it is business. Alright. Growing and is in trading. Growing and manufacture. Growing and manufacture. Composite income. And composite income has to be divided. Has to be separated. So they say you maintain common PNL. You determine your profit first and then we will apply the standard ratio. Though the ratios are not given in Income Tax Act, though the ratios are given in Income Tax Rules. Ratios are not given in Income Tax Act, ratios are given in Income Tax Rules. I hope you are learning, these are the first rules of income tax that you people are learning, which actually belongs to PGBP. Alright. So, Rule 7A, 7B and 8. Rule 7A, 7B and 8. Rule 7 is there for all other agriculture composite. But 7A, 7B and 8, okay? Rule 7A, 7B and 8. 8 is for tea, 7A for rubber, 7B for coffee. Come on, tell me. In rubber, what is the proportion? Agriculture 65, commercial or business income? 35. In tea, agriculture 60, business 40. In coffee, grown and cured, 75, 25. And grown, cured, roasted and grounded. 60, 40, okay, ये हो गया यहाँ का, wait, एक बार और करते, तो क्या 3 round हो जाएगा, 3 round, okay, till now I have spoken about this for 2 times, one more time, okay, this is your agriculture income chapter, I'm teaching you something which belongs here, okay, rule 8, rule 8, agriculture income, non-agriculture income, you tell me, Rule 8, what was for? Rule 8 was for? Hello? Assessee is engaged in the business of growing and manufacturing? India or outside India? This benefit we are giving only to Indian people. If you are doing agriculture, this tea business in Netherlands, then this benefit is not available. 100% foreign income is taxable. Yes or no? 100%, no ratio. Okay? So 60% and 40%. They are giving example also. If 5 lakh rupees is total income, then how much taxable income out of 5 lakh? 40%. 40% of 5 lakh will be 2 lakh. So taxable PGBP 2 lakh. Okay. Although you earn 5 lakh rupees PGBP, we are asking you to pay tax only on 2 lakh. Okay. Can I go ahead? Next. Last bench, just focus here. 7A, assessee is engaged in business of growing and manufacture rubber in India. Rubber in India for 65, 35. Then assessee is engaged in a business of growing and manufacturing coffee in India. Alright, coffee grown and cured by seller. Okay, so only two words, grown and cured. 75 agriculture, 25 commercial or non-agriculture. Coffee grown, cured, roasted and grounded by the seller in India with or without mixing that chicory and like something flavoring. Like sometime you know you get this flavor, mint flavor, that flavor, you understand? So whether you are adding that or not, that is not important. So these words are not with or without. No, they killed it. They only killed a sentence. If with flavor, if something different were there, then I would have focused emphasis on it. But with or without, they are that is not making any sense because they only started wording with flavor or without flavor. All right, 60, 40. This coffee is ready-made coffee. Directly you can drink. All right. Okay, any other case is written here, that is rule number 7. So, which chart should I put on board, you tell me. That one or this one? Okay, so start writing, give the heading. Point number 3, composite income.